Right, we're going to take a look at the humerus. So the humerus is the bone of the upper arm, or what's called the brachium. Okay. And there's multiple features on this bone that you need to know. This is going to be the proximal end. This is going to be the distal end. Okay. So on the proximal end, we've got the head, right? So that remember, the head of the humerus is what articulates with the glenoid cavity of the scapula to make your shoulder joint. Right. The neck of the humerus is what they call an anatomical neck. It isn't a prominent feature. It's just basically where the head is attached to the rest of the bone. I spin this guy around a little bit. We've got two tubercles or tuberosities. Kind of depends on who you talk to. Some people call them tuberosities, some people call them tubercles, or our list calls them tubercles. Tubercles are roughened surfaces because something is attached to a tubercle or a tuberosity or a trochanter, all roughened. This is our greater tubercle, okay, and you can really see how it's roughened here. And then this is our lesser tubercle, okay? There's a little notch right in between the two of those, right? The lesser is again smaller and the greater tubercle is bigger. Okay. Down on the side of the diaphysis is our deltoid tuberosity. That's where your deltoid muscle would be attached. Okay. If we go to the other end, right, we have a number of features. I'm going to come to the anterior view here. So this is at the distal end of our humerus. And these features right here that you see are very smooth. Now, most of the time, we would call a smooth articulating feature a condyle. But on the humerus, they have special names. So the trochlea is this feature right here. Now, this is kind of spool shaped. So in other words, it's wide and it gets narrow and then it gets a little wider. So this is the trochlea. This is the capitulum. Okay, it's kind of like shaped like a ball. All right. So because these would be considered condyles, epicondyles are features that are above the condyles. So this would be our medial epicondyle, and this would be our lateral epicondyle. I'm going to tell you a little trick here to know medial and lateral on the humerus and also on the femur. Heads on any bone that has a head, heads are always on the medial side of the bone. So anything that's on the same side as the head is on the medial side of the bone. So here's our medial epicondyle, very prominent. This is what some people call your funny bone. And here's our lateral epicondyle. You'll see a small fossa here called the coronoid fossa. And on the back, at the distal end, you'll see a much larger fossa. And this is the olecranon fossa. The word olecranon means elbow. Okay. I guess I'll go on and we'll look at the radius and the ulna because they are the bones that make up the forearm. So here's the ulna. One of the things you can do to know that you're looking at an ulna, not a radius, is if you look at the ulna from the side, you see the U right there? So U ulna, okay? So on the proximal end of the ulna, which is the side closest to the humerus, you've got three features, and these you're going to see match up with the names on the radius. So this is going to be the olecranon process. The U is the trochlear notch, and this is the coronoid process. And those are what fit into the end of the humerus. I'm going to show you this in just a second. I'm going to take you to the other end first. At the other end of the ulna is the styloid process. It's a pointy process. So let's just go back and just bear with me while I bring our humerus back in here. Okay. So if you remember, here's our trochlea. Okay, there's our ulna. Okay, so the olecranon process fits into the olecranon fossa. The trochlear notch spins around the trochlea, and the coronoid process fits into the coronoid fossa. Okay? All right, I'm going to keep this guy close by because we're going to look at the radius next. So here is the radius. That's the other bone in the forearm. When you're looking at the forearm from the anatomical position, the radius is going to be lateral and the ulna is going to be medial. The radius is always on the thumb side of your forearm. So the radius has some features here. This sort of cup-shaped feature is the head. Below the head is the neck. And below that is a roughened surface, the radial tuberosity. Okay. And then if we go to the distal end, we've got another styloid process. All right. If I bring our humerus back in, there's our humerus. Now the radius is not considered part of the elbow joint. It does, however, articulate with the humerus. And that capitulum, that round feature, ball-shaped feature, okay, at the distal end of the humerus, is where the head of the radius sits. So it sits up against this, and that cup-shaped part of the head is able to spin around the capitulum. And that's what gives us the ability to do this action. Okay, I need to zoom out a little bit. Sorry about that. And that's the ability to pronate and supinate our forearm.